Apple and their warning, Samsung and its warning. We've got issues in the smartphone market. We've got issues in the data center with memory as well. Yet your stock is up better than 5.5% this morning. I wonder if this is because investors are starting to realize that what you warned about in December isn't a Micron-specific issue, perhaps. It's more of a macro industry-wide issue. Is that continuing to be your read?
That's absolutely right. We announced our earnings December 20th, and at that time we were one of the first ones to come out and talk about some of the challenges related to inventory adjustment in cloud, in enterprise, as well as on the graphics markets. We also talked about CPU shortages impacting demand in the near term. And we also talked about smartphone unit weakness, particularly on the high end. So these are some of the factors, confluence of factors, that resulted in our guidance that we provided for our FQ2 in December to be somewhat weaker than what analysts were expecting. However, to be very clear, these are not Micron-specific issues. These are issues related to our industry, inventory adjustment, as well as CPU shortages. We expect them to work through over the next couple of quarters. Smartphone unit demand, yes, tepid, but what's important to understand is that the content within the smartphones, amount of memory, the amount of flash storage that is needed, actually continues to go up because of multiple cameras, because of AI-driven features in the phones. So yes, I mean, near term, some challenges. Micron continues to execute well on its plans, and we do expect demand environment to improve in the second half of calendar 2019.
So this is great, because you've proven to be sort of a canary in the coal mine on this, and investors suddenly have all these questions, and you're reminding us that, well, you told us so back in December, but you still see this as something where the industry is adjusting. We see these reports of production cuts, 10% out of Apple, et cetera. That I saw as a relatively good sign, because when you see a hardware maker miss, if they're poorly positioned, they're cutting production a lot more than 10% in order to get things rebalanced. You think this is temporary?
Yes, I mean, you know, because the long-term demand trends related to cloud and AI is in very, very early innings. AI-driven servers need 6 times more DRAM in them and 2 times more SSDs in them, and we are in the early innings. And, you know, over the course of next several years, going from less than 5% of servers being AI-driven servers going to 50% by over the course of next several years will drive more demand for memory and storage.
For memory.
Similarly, for memory and storage, I mean DRAM and flash, same thing in smartphones. While again, the unit demand may be somewhat challenged, particularly at the high end, the content continues to increase. And then, of course, you see here at the show, autonomous vehicles, right?
Talk about that.
Yes.
Where should we look? I mean, autonomous vehicles is one area, though I think the rollout of those clearly has taken some time. It's not like we're getting full autonomy in the next couple of years. Then we had Amazon's head of voice on with us yesterday, talking about he's meeting with a lot more than just the smart speaker stuff, about embedding this capability in bike helmets and in all kinds of different devices. Which of those, between autonomous and the 5G-enabled, you know, other devices, which of those do you expect to have the bigger impact on your business?
You know, that's the exciting part about us, that our markets have now diversified, and Micron certainly is executing well to broaden its portfolio, to add high-value solutions, to be able to address all of these markets. And all these markets are mega markets, you know, cloud in the early innings. You know, certainly PC continue to do well, mobile phones, smartphones, autonomous vehicles, IoT. Look at CES, right? I mean, the big thing here is all about AI, it's about 5G, it's about, you know, the driverless vehicles and IoT. All of these trends definitely point to need for more memory, more storage, all these applications. In order for them to deliver the value for their experiences, to address their end markets, they need more memory and more storage.
What
so
about
all
TVs?
Of these are massive markets for us.
Even though streaming is the primary use case that we're seeing there, Apple recently announced that they're putting iTunes on Samsung TVs. There's got to be some buffering there. There should be some room for sophisticated. Are you seeing more demand for NAND, for DRAM from TV manufacturers? How do you expect that to trend, or is that pretty stable?
So all of these consumer markets related to TVs, as well as industrial IoT, surveillance cameras, all of these devices need more memory and more storage. In fact, at Investor Day back in May, we had shown an example of surveillance cameras that when they become more and more AI-driven, they will require more memory and more storage. So that's the exciting part. I mean, it's really the whole realm of IoT. These devices will certainly need more memory, more storage. And as cloud becomes more AI-driven, more data-driven, more intelligent, it unleashes innovation with these IoT of devices, and it drives a virtuous cycle of growth and innovation.
Finally, as this party gets going, I want to go back to data center, because you talked about the smartphone market specifically and how that was kind of a temporary dip that you see. From the mega-scale cloud providers, where we're seeing this dip in memory demand, are you still convinced that that's a short-term thing, or is that a broader macro issue?
No, in terms of the memory, as we just discussed, right, it's really due to inventory adjustments by our customers. Okay. DRAM prices had been going up, so those customers built up inventory, you know, and as the prices and demand and supply caught up, now they are bringing down their inventory levels. So what's important to understand is that the end demand by our customers in their applications continues to be very decent, okay? Mm-hmm. It's really near term. Our demand to us in terms of shipping to our customers is somewhat impacted, and that's because customers are consuming their inventory. And over the course of next couple of quarters, we expect that that consumption of inventory will with them will be caught up to bring their inventory levels to normal levels, so that what they will be shipping out in terms of DRAM and flash will be caught up with respect to what we are shipping into them. So over a couple of quarters, we expect balance, and second half of the year, we expect demand trend to be stronger than in the first half.